Okay, let me proceed with the diagram. Here, first, due to electrostatic repulsive force, the A and B will repel, and both are having same mass. So when the particle B collides with the wall, where the particle A will be is what you have to search it. So when B comes and about to strike the wall, it will have velocity V1, and A will also undergo displacement. So what is the suppression? So the B has undergone displacement of 20 centimeter, and already this was separated by 20. So here, the remaining distance, this should be 20. So this should be 60 centimeter between them. Why they should undergo? Because they're having same mass, and what are the force that is acting is electrostatic force.
Pondo, Virana.
Is somebody mute? Rishi, mute pa. Okay, man. How come I suddenly brought this diagram? Look at the net force acting on the system. Look at the net force acting on system. Zero, no? So therefore, net force acting on system is zero for this case. So center of mass will not shift. And both masses are same. So therefore, the displacement of B should be equal to displacement of A. Earlier, this was the position of B. This was the position of A.
What is M2?
You're asking something, somebody?
What is M2?
Masses are different. Oh, sorry, I didn't see. M2 is 1 kg. MAMB, it is okay. I didn't check the data. Oh, masses are different. I'll make correction problem. Okay, a little bit we have to. I thought masses same. Okay, that slight modification will come in the numerical. Okay, no, the same thing. Net horizontal force acting on system is zero on the particles. So therefore, center of mass will not shift. Look at the masses, 0.5 kg, 1 kg. When this reaches the wall, so here I'll go for displacement formula like this. M1 X1 equal to M2 X2. What is M1? M1 is, I think I'll go for MA. MA XA is equal to symbols accordingly will take it. What is MA? 0.5 XA. This MB is 1 into XB. So XA is equal to 2 XB. The displacement of block will be twice the displacement of block B when the block B reaches the wall. So here block B, it will have velocity VB, you write it. Then where the block A will be, block A is what happened, will reach the end of the spring. Any reason for that? Look at the displacement of block B. How much is undergone displacement? XB. So how much the block A will undergo displacement of 40 centimeter, no? So therefore the block A will reach here. It will have velocity VA. So what is the separation between them will be 40 plus 20. This total will be 80 centimeter. I think I have given enough information in the diagram itself. What is the state of block A and B? This is just about to strike the spring. So X and XB values we know. So if XB is 20 centimeter, XA will be 40 centimeter. Have this. Then how to get this VA and VB? Can you apply conditional mechanical energy? Yes, initial interaction potential G. both are having same charge, so k q square by 20 centimeter 0.2 should be equal to k q square. What is the separation? Will be 80 centimeter. Plus m a v a square plus m b v b square. Both are unknowns, so I'll go for this particular thing. Net force acting on system is zero, so initial momentum equal to final momentum zero. Final momentum m b v b minus m a v a. So with this, I will get the speed of the block A and B. After this, what will happen? The block B will go collide inelastically. The block will collide inelastically. Very next moment after collision, the block B will come to rest after collision. So let this be BA. This will come to rest. So this will be 0.8 meter, you write it. And now what will happen? The electrostatic force will be still acting. So what it'll do, it will further accelerate and the spring will get compressed and will get a maximum compression, where the block A will be instantaneous rest it is. This will be the maximum compression. He's asking this maximum compression, calculate velocity of A when it comes in contact with the spring. That is what this one. So how to calculate this maximum compression? So look at from second and third diagram. Can you apply conservation of mechanics? What are the forces acting? Electrostatic force. The forces that will be acting are electrostatic force and also the spring force. No, both are conservative. So you can take help of conservation of mechanical energy. So writing that equations. These are very popular. So questions of this kind, they really show a lot of interest, especially conservation of momentum, conservation of mechanical energy in various fields. Just put some effort on such numericals, no? Okay, let's write equation between second and third diagram. So K Q square 0.8 plus the kinetic energy will be 0.8 plus xm plus k xm square by 2. You look at this question like, sir, why can't we apply between the first and the third diagram directly conservation of energy? Because some energy is lost. Some energy is lost due to collision. So that's why what happened, I'm not applying within first and second diagram. Are you looking at this? Some energy is lost here, no? Due to collision. So that's why you can't directly write between 1 and 3. So therefore the equation has ended up like this. So we'll get the value of VA and VB from here, and we'll get the value of VA. Then we can get the value of XM. The answers are given. You should not directly apply between the first and the third diagram. Any reason for that? Because in the second diagram, some energy is lost, no? So energy is not conserved from 1 to 3. Some energy is lost due to collision, inelastic collision. So when you are applying conservation of mechanical energy between any two positions, no, you have to be alert a little bit, like, is there any loss of energy of the system anywhere? Okay, do make observation. Some center of mass idea, conservation of momentum, conservation of mechanical energy. Completed. Okay, we'll take the now I'm bringing tension in the strings into the picture. Okay, read the question. There are three charged particles. Yeah. The string connecting A and B suddenly snaps. I think this particular string is saying. What will happen to in that case? What the maximum speed of C during the resulting motion? Okay, we'll take help of the diagram. Initially, they will move. This is A. I need some diagonal space if needed. Okay, this is A, B, and this is C. Okay, this string is snapped. So they're released from rest, I'll snap it. What will happen to after that? They're on smooth horizontal surface and all are identical. The balls are in charge Q, the strings are taut. What is the maximum speed of resulting motion? So Q equal to 1 microcoulomb. So is there no charge on C particle? Particle C is a neutral particle. Only A and B are charged here. So any electrostatic force will act? Electrostatic force will act here. And what is the state of them? They are at rest. This is what happens. Now, as the moment the electrostatic force, when it's acting, as it starts acting here, no? So what will happen to string? String will become taut. So a tension will start acting. Okay, this tension will accelerate the charge particle. No? What is the resulting motion of the charge particle B? A and B, how do, because of tension and F and electrostatic force, they'll try to move in this direction. The path of A should be somewhere like this. The yellow color will show the path of C, and the blue color dotted line will show the path of is that okay? No. So if you can manage this much, I think you can comfortably write the equation. So what can be diagram is asking maximum velocity. So somewhere at a situation, okay, I have to bring maximum and shift the diagram. So how do A and B? A and B will move in a plane, whereas C will move vertically up, or C will move along y-axis. So somewhere at a position where all three will be on same horizontal line. B, okay, this is C. What is the velocity of C? Will be like this. What about the velocity of A? I'm going to write like this. You have to really justify why no. Here I'm showing the A and B will move in a plane, but here I'm showing only they're moving along y-axis. Any reason?
Velocity of center of mass is zero.
Okay, fine. I'm not saying it's wrong. No. Here, why I'm not showing VAX?
Along the string, there should not be any velocity.
Yeah, that one, no? So here, string is inextensible, no? Somewhere word is there. Yeah. Inextensible, insulating inextensible thread. So this inextensible thread matters a lot. Though what will happen when A and B will be moving in a plane, the moment A, B, C come on horizontal line, the velocity of particles along this direction, what happened will be nullified. Is that okay? Because here I am showing dotted line. Suddenly, if I don't indicate, means I should give account of that, what will happen to that x component of velocities, no? So the x component of velocities will be nullified here. So very, very next moment, what will happen to next moment? So because of this, here electrostatic force, still it be acting here. Some other value, need not be always this, some other value. And next moment, how do? The string is taut, VAY, this particular thing, and there's a VAY. So it's the next position of the charged particle, it'll be like this. The C will be somewhere here. This will be E. String will be taut, some other tension. T double dash, you write it. Here, electrostatic force. So here the particle C will have some velocity. It will be less than VC. This will be less than VC. On what basis I can say? Look at the tension T double dash. How do it lag? It lagged opposite to VC. No, a component of velocity of tension will act against the VC double dash, velocity of charge, velocity of particle C. So therefore VC double dash should be less than VC. Somewhere you take in between diagram, the particle C will have velocity that will be less than this. So therefore this is the maximum is what I'll measure. How to get this VC max is what our question. Is it okay? I think I explained the situation, what actually going on. Can we apply conservation of mechanical energy? Conservation of momentum can we apply? Yes, it is. So what is the net force along y-axis? So we'll define the axis here. The net force on the system along y-axis zero, initial momentum zero. final momentum will be zero. So initial momentum zero. Final momentum should be equal to m vcy 2m vby. No velocity along AB, no, here electrostatic force will act in this direction. Clear this. And look at the tension. The tension is acting in this direction. So initial, the moment you release, this will be. Now how the motion of charge particle, the charge particle will move. There's a path of B. There's a path of A. I think somewhere, it should move like this. So when it becomes so when it becomes horizontal, so how the velocity of A and B will be? Velocity of A and B will be normal to the string because the string is inextensible, no? If there is a velocity like this, if I put any velocity, any problem with this? If I put any velocity, component of velocity, sir, any problem will arise with this? You are definitely you are saying that the length of string will increase, no? The length of string will increase. But they will never have velocity? No, they will have velocity here. But the moment when the string becomes horizontal, the string will nullify it. So when the string becomes horizontal, you have to show only the vertical components of particle C and B. Can we apply all together the this VC max is needed, no? Can we apply conservation of mechanical? That's what my question. Okay, there's some relationship we have. VCy equal to 2 VBy. This we'll call it as equation 1. And VAy equal to VBy. That's why I wrote 2M VBy. Some of you are asking this, why this is. I'll write equation. M VAy. Since VAy equal to VBy, substituting, we'll get this equation on. Okay, now this VCy, so this is what the maximum, what we are supposed to calculate. How to bring, so how to eliminate VBY. Can you apply conservation of mechanical? What about the tension, role of tension? Tension does positive work on the C, no? And it does negative work on A and B. Net work done by tension will be zero. Net work done tension is zero. Net work done by tension on the system is zero. So what is the only force doing work? Electrostatic force. What is the electrostatic force? Conservative force. So I'll apply conservation of mechanical energy. So initial length of the string is equal to L, no? So K Q square L should be equal to K Q square 2L. Should be equal to MVC square by 2 plus 2M, or say write individually MVAy square MVBy square by 2. Okay, fine. This condition, I think so. Sometimes students in exam know. They need not to bother this. If nothing happens, so it's a y v x is zero. Because sometimes students, they just categorically go diagram, they'll come to know that x component will be zero. You need not to analyze in depth in exam. If they ask you something work done or any other thing, you have to go for it. So without condition of mechanics, can you solve? I think the particle B will move in a plane, no? We should generate equation solving. I think it is really very troublesome. If you want to try it, you look at the path of B, it's very difficult to generate that equations, that one, and show that even to show that work done by tension, it's very difficult. Because for that, what you should know, work done by tension on the B, you should know the work done by tension on the B, and work done by tension on the particle C, very easy. While the displacement is undergone, we can make it component, and this angle will be changing. Tension magnitude also will be changing. So definitely this particular quantity, I'm assuming that's why I'm getting answer. But showing this proof is, I didn't get, definitely I can say. Anybody, if you want, you can try. Very honestly, I'm telling. If you want, you can try by kinematics method, work done by tension on the particle B, I, and C, and work out. No? Very lengthy calculations will end up. Is that okay? So I'll write down the answer. Maximum speed is 2 meters per second. The answer is, check afterwards. String inextensible, that's why x component of velocities will be zero. So what about here, sir? Here, what about any velocities? How the velocities will be? Definitely here, what happened? It will have x and y components. Because again, now what happened? They'll start coming together. So here you can show the velocities components, Vay and Vax. It will have, it'll undergo retardation. Vay keeps on decreases, Vax starts increasing here. Okay, I'll go for next question. Okay, now simple idea based one. Or tomorrow, equal to when I discuss equal minus dV by this, there I'll discuss. We'll take the next another one. Some very old question, long back I wrote. A rod of mass m and length 3L is released from rest. Okay, sorry for disturbance. So we have a rod of mass m and length 3L is released with point charge rod length L, no, it is. This is 3L. Some diagram mistake is there. A rod of mass m and length 3L is raised from rest with point charge Q mounted to Q. Mounted at one end and other end of rod is hinged on the ground. A point charge minus Q is fixed at a distance 2L from the rod and the 4L it is. 3L plus L, 4L from the ground as shown. Find the angular velocity of the rod when it becomes horizontal. Work done by electrostatic force. So the overall diagram I'll give it. The diagram. It's a light rigid rod. So there's a positive charge 2Q. The range. So here the negative charge minus Q. Length it is. Okay, the effect of gravity also you have to take it. Mass of the rod M, length is 3L. This total length is 4L. Or we'll break up. This is 3L. This L. This is a fixed here. It cannot move. So this everything is a ground. Okay, there's a basic diagram which is there. I'm just giving it. Okay, I'll release from rest. The system is released from rest. Now what will happen? It's asking what will be the angular velocity of the rod when it becomes horizontal. What makes it to be horizontal? You start with this. The electrostatic force will act here. Fe. So under action of this electrostatic force, the rod starts swinging. No? So when we have some arbitrary position, you take it here. So how the electrostatic force, so the electrostatic force acting will be now in this direction. So that electrostatic force which is acting, is it constant or variable? It will be a variable force. Continuously will be varying that one. And by the time when the rod becomes horizontal, what will be the angular velocity of the rod? When it becomes horizontal, this will be the position. How to get this? So shall we take help of torque because we know how to calculate torque. So shall we apply the torque idea? Yes, you can apply torque, it'll be lengthy. Again, you have to depend on integration. Definitely you have to take help of integration. So without any mathematics, can we manage? That's what this question is. Yes. So the angular velocity is asking here, this angular velocity. Can I apply conservation of mechanical energy? Yes, we'll apply conservation of mechanical. So initial, can we apply conservation of, what are the forces that'll be acting? The weight. Not visible, I'll take it. MG, no? So what are the forces that'll be doing work on the system? The weight as well as electrostatic force. Even the reaction force will be acting, but the displacement of point of the inch will be zero. So work done by reaction forces will be zero. So therefore, only forces that are doing work are the electrostatic force and the weight. So decrease in gravitational potential energy, mg into 3L by 2. This one. Then initial k 2q minus q, 3L plus, this will be 4L, no? This will be, so this everything will become 5L. It should be equal to kinetic energy of the rod. Mass of the rod is how much? M, no? Particle is also having mass. Okay, only mass of the earth. So this will be m into 3L whole square by 3. Moment of inertia, ml square by 3 into omega square by 2. Kinetic energy of the rod plus interaction potential energy. So what is interaction potential energy? Will be k2q minus q by L. The problem has become very simple by just applying conservation of mechanical energy. We know all the quantities, just substituting that one, we'll get the omega. Work done by electrostatic force is telling. Work done by electrostatic force, what you should write? Work done by electrostatic force is equal to change in potential energy, no? So initial kinetic, initial interaction potential energy. How much it is? K2q minus q. It should be equal to minus delta u, no? Uf minus ui. So ui minus uf. What is ui? Ui will be k2q minus q by phi l minus of k2q minus q by l. This will be the work done by electrostatic force. Work done by electrostatic force, what is the basic formula? Minus delta U. Delta U is more final minus initial. So negative of negative. So this will be equal. Substitute UI and UF with sign. I think that's the most easiest way of this one. Say work done by electrostatic force, you can find out by the torque method. I think you really enjoy the mathematics. What happened to Fe? The magnitude varies. What happened to direction? It also changes. It'll be really troublesome for you. In a very simplified way, I'm just analyzing like this. So do take help of this energy aspect. It will really help us a lot. That's why all problems are picked up. Just only keeping in mind. We do have two approach. One, integration mathematics approach. Other, energy. In energy method, we are avoiding mathematics. That is the only advantage of this one. Okay, take this one. Yeah. There are the above system of charges is let free to move. What happens to arrangement? All are having same mass. That the cube shape shrink or expand, calculate the velocity of each. Assume mass of each point charge is m, and the charges here is showing that one. So can you remember yesterday we have concluded, I think day before yesterday. Oh, okay, I think it was yesterday, that one, potential energy. When you can say system shrink or expand, shall we take help of the force method or shall we take help of energy method? Even in force method, we can predict whether the system will shrink or expand. Then what is the condition? You have to check the force acting on individual charge particle and in what direction it will undergo displacement. With that, you can say shrink or expand. Another alternative, calculate total potential energy of system. If it comes negative, the system will shrink. If it comes positive, the system will expand. So which approach is the best? The second one, how to calculate interaction potential energy is what you have to get in diagram. Look at the cube. The opposite, the charges on opposite edges will be negative, no? Will be opposite charges. You can see like here minus Q plus Q. You look at this configuration that plays like this. So give the number for them. Oh. Okay, calculate interaction potentials. How many charges are there? Altogether, there are 8 charges are there, no? We have to get all that interactions. We have to get back all that interactions here. So if you know permutation, if you know some combination S, you can easily work out, or you can write down there. No. So how many types of interactions are there? At least I'm saying how many types of interaction. Sir, what do you mean by type? You look at the interaction between 192. Is it similar to the interaction between 192 is similar to that between 198? Definitely. Look at the interaction between 12, 18 and 14. Will be same, no? Look at the interaction between 12 and 13. They're different. 13 will become diagonal. Similar, the interaction between 12, 13 and 16. Compare all three. All three are different, no? So 12, the interaction between 12, 13 and 16. They are different. So like that, how many types of interactions are there here? The side, diagonal, and diagonally opposite corner. So these are the three types of interactions are there. So the total interaction potential will be interaction due to each side. Don't say face, better say like interaction due to each side. Or edge, anything you can prefer. This is one thing. Next, interaction due to diagonal. Plus interaction due to diagonally opposite corner. I think I'll classify the interactions here. Due to side, how many are there? How many sides will come? A cube, how many sides will have? 12. 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, that one in each face. So you can look at that. So 12 are there. So 12 into K, Q, minus Q, L. And then we'll go for diagonal. So how many diagonals it will have here? I think it'll also be 12. No? For each face, there'll be 2. 6 faces are there. So 12 K for diagonal, it will be positive. Minus Q, L root 2. Diagonally opposite corner. How many such interactions will be there? Example 1, 6, 3, 8. 4, 5 and 2, 7. So there'll be 4 interactions will be there. So K minus Q, one will be positive, other will be negative. Y. So this will be L root 3. So what do we get is K Q square L, take it outside. This will be minus 12 plus 12 root 2 minus 4 by root 3. Check the value. This is the initial interaction potential when I released. I'll check the value of UI. If it turns up negative, system will shrink. If it comes positive, system will expand. Is that okay? So you can simplify. So you do get some set of questions where many point charges are there. Do identify, categorize the type of interactions that'll be sufficient. Anybody value of this? Minus 12 root 2. 5.8, I think we'll end up with 5.8. Nearest value. So this will be minus 5.8 K Q square L. So I got the negative value. So what I should interpret? UI. I'll write it here. Minus 5.8 K Q square L. So what do the negative sign? The system will shrink. So negative sign indicates system shrinks. Okay, fine. No. But what is our question? Our question was something calculate velocity. So what happens to the arrangement shrinks? What happens to arrangement? Does it the cube shape shrink or expand? So it will shrink. It will not expand. Then after this, calculate velocity of each charge when the side length of the cube changes from L to NL. And the mass of each point charge is m. How to get the speed? How it is possible? How to get speed of each point charge? That is telling each point charge. Okay, let's do one thing. We'll take the center of mass idea. What is the net electrostatic force? Is a mutual force, no? So what is the net force acting on the system? Will be zero. So finally, if they shrink, means where do they will meet? At the center of mass of system. So where is the center of mass of system? Center of the cube. So definitely, the force acting on each charge will be same. Of course, magnitude will be same. Directions will be different. So finally, where all the charged particles will meet? At the center of the cube. At the center of mass of the cube. So definitely, what happen? You look at the displacement of all will be same. So therefore, what happen? All will have same speed. How to bring that answer? I'll go for next kinetic energy one. So shall we go for the same thing? Ui plus ki equal to uf plus kf. Initial interaction potential, that we know it, minus 5.8 k q square l. The release from rest, uf will be minus 5.8 k q square. Shall we write nl only? Because the side length of the cube will shrink from L to NL plus 8m v square by 2. What is v? Speed of each point charge. Okay, so in a simplified way, we are concluding this particular problem.
Sir, can you repeat why did you take the velocity same for all the particles, sir?
The net force acting on the system. I think I'll justify the statement with the help of some. What is the net electrostatic force acting on the system? Net total is zero, no? Because electrostatics is the mutual force. So where do they'll meet finally? I'm saying the system will shrink means. If they shrink means, where they should meet? They should meet at center of mass. I'll write the explanation here. This part as the net force, as the net force on system of charges is zero. So and system shrinks. So what will happen to delta RCM? Will zero. So all the particles will meet at center of mass of system. Then all will undergo same displacement because that center of mass will be located symmetrically with respect to every point, will be equidistant from every point of charge particle. So in a given time, all are having same displacement. So you look at the speed now. All must have same speed. Is it okay? So how to justify that the same speed? I'm just taking idea of the center of mass. Or else what you should do? Calculate the magnitude of force acting on each particle. On particle one, due to remaining seven particles. Then come for particle two, due to remaining other seven particles. Mathematically, that you can. So since we know center of mass idea, no? So with that, what happened? I'm just concluding this. Why that eight? The writing sir, eight is very important.
Sir, you're telling that the net displacement and the net time taken is zero. But that will just give us, that will just tell us that the average velocity of all the particles will be same, but we cannot comment about it at any one instance. For example, if one particle is moving faster compared to other particles in the beginning, but at then, the end it is slower.
Not possible. Check it, the symmetry, no? Look at the symmetry, that one. Look at all. It's not only one plus minus, no? The charges are arranged in such a way that so it depends the force acting on any one particle at any instant of time when it is shrinking, no, will be same. The direction will be different. But how do that force will be? That force will be directed towards center of mass. This is what happens. So the best thing is pick up any two charged particles, get the direction of force. Forces will be...
If the system they give, like in this case, it is symmetrical. But if it is not symmetrical,
then what happens?
Then we should calculate for each and every particle.
So. Yeah, every particle that will be. So the alignment of charges is very important. You must make observation of alignment of charges before entering into the problem. Otherwise, we'll be in big trouble. Okay, so there's a thing. So we'll take this one. Okay, take the read this question. Oh, we have so many. I'll push all them. I think we can at least finish off this question. Read one. Question number 92, something number is there. Three charges Q, 3Q and 2LQ are to be placed on a straight line AB having 12 centimeter length. Two of the charges must be placed at the end points A and B, and the third charge can be placed anywhere between A and B. Find the position of each charge if the potential of system is to be minimum. So just it's bringing some minimum potential, how the charges must be aligned so that the interaction potential of the system should be minimum, not of any one. The total system, the interaction potential should be minimum. So there is a straight line. This is AB. So three charges are there, Q, 3Q and 2LQ. The distance between A and B is 12 centimeter. How they should be positioned so that it'll be minimum. You must be ready with no questions of this one. I took three linear, that played on straight line. I may give some 5-point charges. I may ask them to place in some, on a triangle, then some at hexagon, 4, 5, at hexagon, 6 corners are there, no? 6-point charges. Different types of charge system will be there. How to minimize potential energy and how the orientation should be. Okay, let's go for the basic potential energy definition.
Maximum charges should be placed the farthest.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. Got it, yeah. Yeah, that's the basic idea. So let's do one thing. We'll go for I'll switch off video. Some problem may come. Interaction potential energy depends on interaction potential depends on what? K, Q1, Q2, and X. That's the basic definition. Directly we'll take help of this definition. When do it be minimum? See, here in the problem, we do have three charges, no? We do have three charges. Q1, Q2, 3Q. See, just analyze once. It's like this. So the interaction will be, say, like a K, Q1, Q2, and say X12. Interaction K, Q1, Q3, X13. U23, K, Q2, Q3, X23. So this product Q1, Q2, Q, Q1, Q3, these are the must, no? But the separation between 1, 2 or 1, 3 and 2, 3, that matters a lot, no? I'm trying to generate the idea. The separation between the product of Q1, Q2, Q1, Q3, Q2, Q3. You put in any orientation, that product, this numerator will be same, no? But look at the denominator. If this, the when this particular, it will be minimum. When this particular denominator open is having maximum value, that two what happen? I look the charge 3q and 12q, the product of these two. If they are separated by maximum distance, then only it will be minimum, no? I say like instead of all this, you better draw some three diagram and very and just analyze it rather than if you are unable to use mathematics, go for like this. I don't know. I'll start it like this. Q. 3Q. Nothing wrong. That is straight away. Start here. So will this be minimum? Now look at this. The interaction between 2LQ, 3Q. The separation is less, no? So I'll start another one. 3Q. Q, I'll bring it. What is the next combination? Okay, Q, Q in between. 3Q and this is 12Q. Now look at now. What is the other alternative? Other alternative will be 12Q, I'll bring in between. I think these are the some possibilities what we can do here. Nothing wrong if you think it this way also. You are just analyzing. No? It's not that something, the idea of the problem by seeing question only, it should strike, need not. You analyze. Try it in different way. Okay, no. Work out here, no. In every problem, so call this is one. This two will give name. This is three, no? Already I given, no? So in every problem, what happened? This KQ1, Q2, KQ1, Q3, KQ2, Q3. In all the configurations, it will be there, no? But look at that X12, X13, X23, the interactions. That matters. So which one will give the minimum potential here? I think when the charges which are having more magnitude, if they are separated by larger distance, then the potential will be minimum, no? Because you know, for all three cases, the product of K, Q1, Q2, this product will be same. Q3, so 3Q square between these two, this one. So when the potential will be minimum, I'll change. So I'll continue. Same thing that will be. So this is a Q, no? Okay, now come for this. Here what happened? When the product of charges will happen when the charges which are having more magnitude, if they are separated by more distance, if the distance of them is more, then what happened? The potential will be minimum. So among all three, what happened? This will provide minimum potential energy. So let me take this is X and this distance, let it be L. Write the equation. Are you getting no? So I'm so why only you picked up the third diagram? Here minimum not possible. So here it will be greater than minimum. This one. This will be greater than minimum. So why only you picked up the third one? The reason is those charges which are having more magnitude, they must be separated by larger distance so that you can make minimum potential. You see this one. U is proportional to Q square by X, no? This Q square will be same for all three, but X will determine whether it's a minimum. If you maximize X, then U will be minimum. So this configuration will maximize X here. X means not this X, the distance between the charges which are having more magnitude. That should be that value of x should be more. Then only potential will be minimum. So write down the equation. Total interaction potential will be 3k q square x plus 36 k q square by l. 12 k q square l minus x. Differentiate this du by dx and equate to 0. Anybody value of x?
4.
X equal to how much? 4.
4 centimeters.
Four centimeter from 3Q. Measure from 3Q. So when the potential is minimum, when the distance between the product, when the distance between the charges of larger magnitude is more, the potential is minimum. I think I'll write that particular statement. The potential of system will be minimum when charges of larger magnitude separated by more distance. Is it okay now? So I think there's the idea on which I assumed the third diagram. So, or shall I put in simple way? They say like a still, sir, we are not getting why you are writing this statement. You calculate potential in the first case, second case, third case, compare all. The third case will be minimum. It's over. Then you can come and justify this statement. So if nothing flashes for you in exam, no, what are the, yes, say only three charges are there. You can do experiment. So if this idea, if this idea doesn't flash, what to do? This idea doesn't flashes. Three charges are there. There are only three possible combinations. No, in all three combinations, if you have a time, calculate potential energy, among all that, which is the least, that will be the answer. So in exams, finally, what matters, like you got answer or not, how you got answer, immaterial. Okay, so tomorrow I'll continue with the electric potential concept. Tomorrow I'll start the electric potential concept. Okay, fine. Okay, all of you. Thank you, all of you. We'll meet tomorrow. Okay, take care here.